Lynda Jean Cordova Carter was born July 24, 1951 in Phoenix, Arizona to her parents Juanita Cordova and Colby Carter. She has a brother Vincent and a sister Pamela. Her father is of English and Scots-Irish ancestry. Her mother is of Mexican, Spanish, and French descent. From an early age, her family could tell that Lynda was very outgoing and liked to put on shows and perform around the house. By the time she was five, Lynda had started performing in little kids' plays and even appeared on TV performing on Lou King's talent show. After learning how to play guitar and piano, Lynda wanted to play music all the time. In her freshman year of high school, Lynda joined a band called Just Us, and then when she was 16, she joined a second band called The Relatives. The drummer for The Relatives was Gary Berghoff, who later became a famous actor playing Corporal Walter Eugene Radar O'Reilly in the movie MASH. He was also a regular on The Match Game, appearing in over 140 episodes. The Relatives band got such a following in Phoenix that they were hired by the Sahara Casino in Las Vegas to come play for 3 months during the summer. Lynda was not old enough to legally be in a casino, so she had to go in through the kitchen service doors, perform, and then leave out the same way. After graduating high school, Lynda attended Arizona State University, where she was voted most talented person in school, which led to her decision to drop out and pursue a career in music. In 1970, Lynda auditioned for and was hired by the Garfin Gathering Band, whose leader Howard Garfin had just booked a long tour on the Nevada Silver Circuit, playing casinos in Lake Tahoe, Carson City, Reno, and Vegas. After almost 2 years with them, and at the start of 1972, Lynda decided to leave the band and return home to Arizona, where she wanted to focus on acting. While taking some local acting classes, Lynda decided to enter the Miss Arizona Beauty Contest, mainly because she wanted to compete in the talent part of the show. But the darndest thing happened. She ended up winning the title and was automatically entered into the Miss World USA pageant to represent the state of Arizona. Very excited about having just won Miss Arizona, Lynda knew that she had little time to get ready for the national stage, so she had to work daily on her routines along with her talent performances. She was also preparing for any questions she thought they might ask her. She was taking this very serious. By the day of the big competition, Lynda was feeling pretty confident. She knew that she had made a lot of progress these last few weeks, and she was ready to show the world. And boy, did she. Lynda ended up winning or placing very high in each of the competitions. When the judges conferred, it was unanimous. Lynda Carter was now Miss USA. Winning the Miss USA title brought a lot of attention to her and allowed her to compete later in the year at the 1972 Miss World pageant held at the Royal Albert Hall in London, England. Practicing and entering her third competition in just months, Lynda placed 15 out of 53 of the most beautiful and talented women in the world. She was a little tired afterwards, she said. In 1973, Lynda moved to New York and started taking acting classes at several different acting schools. She chose specific schools for each discipline of acting that she wanted to learn about. She was also constantly making appearances around the country as Miss USA. She had started trying to go to auditions, but hadn't landed any roles. But in 1974, she auditioned and landed a part in the episode called Roots of Anger on the TV police drama Nakia. Around the same time, ABC had just aired a TV movie called Wonder Woman. It was produced by Warner Brothers and had Kathy Lee Crosby playing Wonder Woman. ABC had high expectations for the TV movie, but its ratings came in really low. Warner Brothers and ABC studied the feedback from the viewers and decided to give it another try, but this time they would stick closer to the original comic book and use the traditional backstory and costume of Wonder Woman. Not only that, but they also wanted a new actress to play Wonder Woman, which led to an intense talent search. Lynda was informed of the talent search by a production manager while she was performing in Bob Hope's USO television special. Not wasting any time, Lynda contacted them and went in for an audition. The following week, they called her back for another audition, but this time the directors and producers were on hand. They told her that she was perfect for the part, not just because of her beauty, but because her acting was great, and when they had her doing the jumps and running, she looked natural and more athletic than any of the other women. They also added that her darker hair and more exotic look fit better for the character's backstory. Lynda was hired and filming started in early 1975 for the second TV movie. This time it was called The New Original Wonder Woman. After filming was over, it was back to acting classes and more auditions for Lynda. Finally, in November of 1975, the TV movie aired on ABC and scored a huge rating. People really loved this version of Wonder Woman. Lynda received a call that said, it was a hit and the network ordered two more one-hour movies to be made. She called her family who had watched the movie and told them the news. Everyone was so happy. 1976 started out busy for Lynda. She went right to work filming the first one-hour movie when calls started coming in for her to audition for other television parts. Having had a moment in the previous year where her bank account was down to under $20, Lynda decided to take all the parts that came her way. But after filming the second one-hour special, the production team told her that she should get more picky about the roles she accepts. One producer told her, "You were fantastic. These movies are really good and you are going to be a star." With the money that she had just made for filming the two movies, along with all of the positive feedback she was receiving, Lynda decided to try that theory out. When the producer of Starsky and Hutch asked her to appear in an upcoming episode, she told him, "Only if it's a major part and written for me." He agreed and said he would send her the script when it was ready. In the meantime, the first of the two movies aired on ABC and did even better than the one before. With the next one scheduled to air in a couple weeks, the Starsky and Hutch producer called her back and said, "The script is ready and written for your approval. It will be a two-part episode called The Las Vegas Strangler, and you are the co-star." Lynda was excited and went to work on it. Right about that time, the second movie aired, and again the ratings went up even more. ABC made an offer to purchase 11 more episodes. A generous offer was given to Lynda, and she accepted. It was time to focus on Wonder Woman full-time. The Starsky and Hutch two-part series was promoted by the producers as starring Lynda Carter, and both ended up becoming two of their highest-rated episodes of 1976. As the 11 episodes of Wonder Woman ran out in February of 1977, ABC claimed that the show had a lower profit margin than any of their other shows due to the cost of production, so they decided to hold off on making another offer. The producers of Wonder Woman were shocked. They had just brought in all these viewers and were not going to sit around and get lowballed by a deal on ABC. Instead, they went to CBS and worked out an even better deal for season 2. They were signed for 22 episodes and had a plan to get the budget under control. So far, all of the episodes had taken place in the 1940s, just like the comic books. Building all of these old sets was costing all the extra money. This time, they would bring Wonder Woman into the current era, so they could use normal sets and locations. In order to do this, they had to explain in the show that Diana, Wonder Woman, aged at a slower rate than other people. That is how she could look the same 35 years into the future. Unfortunately, this meant that the rest of the cast was changed out, except for actor Lyle Wagner, who played Steve Trevor in all of the previous episodes. This time, he would play Steve Trevor Jr., the 35-year-old son all grown up. They even did a flashback scene that had Wonder Woman looking at an old picture and it showed the son as a little kid to add realism to the change. The show continued on and a third season was purchased with 24 more episodes, but by the beginning of 1979 it had dropped in the ratings to 60th out of 114 shows. CBS went ahead and moved The Incredible Hulk into the time slot and brought in a new show called The Dukes of Hazzard to follow it. Wonder Woman was not re-signed. As all of this was happening, Lynda had just released her first studio album called Portrait. She had also just signed a deal to have some TV specials, so instead of dwelling on the cancellation of Wonder Woman, she instead focused on her musical career as Lynda Carter. Click the video on the left if you want to see the history of Gal Gadot and how she became Wonder Woman. There's a lot of similarities there. Click the video on the right to go to ComicGeddon TV where you can learn more about Wonder Woman. Don't be scared to subscribe.